Some people say football is the all-American sport. The competition, the fans, the tailgates, the team colors, the hype. Definitely the hype. According to the Green Bay Packers Revenue Department, NFL teams divided more than $6 billion for the first time in 2014. In 2015, the National Football League made more than any event ever televised in the history of television. And that's just in the Super Bowl. Yeah, it's a time when everybody supports their teams and flies their jerseys, bets money on their teams and their favorite players. Stadiums are sold out, and the rest of America is tuned in from a TV screen. But this story isn't about team colors,
all right, buddy, go ahead.
Or fans, or the money that is made by professional football.
All right, now you throw it back.
It isn't even about football. It's about where a journey begins. This is the Arbor View Junior Aggies 2015 football team, led by Coach Brett Ridenour, a team made up of kids from 11 to 14 years old, some coming aboard for the first season, others playing their third and final season. One thing was for sure, they were about to go through one of the most memorable journeys of their life, and they were going to do it together.
I got one. All right,
what?
Just copy about what I say.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
Okay, let's go.
Day by day.
Wait,
day by day.
They were your average young kids, of course. Some were one season away from going to high school. But these particular kids had a goal this year: to become the 2015 NYS Junior Football League champions.
Chance to do it then.
Chance to do it then.
We should win.
We should win.
Let's be back cold.
Let's be back cold.
Chance to win it, go by.
Chance to win it, go by.
If we should lose.
We should lose.
Let's stand by the road.
Stand by the road.
When I met this group of kids, they had already played most of the season. What amazed me was the closeness of the players. They played and practiced with a sort of compassion for each other. During interviews, most of the players and coaches all said one thing that stood out to me: how they all considered each other family.
My teammates are great. They're like brothers to me.
I'm super confident in them, and I can trust everyone.
I think, you know, having the kids trust on the coaching staff, also having the coach staff trust on the kids, and most important, having the kids trust each other. That's why we're here in the championship game. Love.
Touchdown, Duck!
Love. I mean, I do have love in my heart for kids, my family, but to have a new appreciation of love. That's what I have for these kids. I want them to go out as champions.
I've been on several levels of coaching. One thing that I do realize, certain kids you can push, certain kids you can't push. The good thing about this team, they're good. So you can be rah-rah with them, or you can put them to the side and say, hey, this is what I need you to do.
I brought this out, it's called a chain. A chain is stronger than its weakest link. There's no weak links on this team.
Team bond, when you hang out with them outside of, when you really make a friendship with them and a bond, you play better together.
Every kid I spoke with said the same thing about his teammates. They're my brothers. One of the coaches even told me they fight for each other when they go into battle, like soldiers.
Got it?
Yes, so.
Got it?
Yes, so.
Louder!
Louder!
Y'all
better believe that, especially
hey,
today.
Bring it up this way. We don't start until we ain't about to be conquered.
Yep,
after a rough start and a long season, the Aggies were almost undefeated, with only one loss coming the first week of the season to the Bishop Gorman Gators. Now, after a long, hard journey, they had one more team to beat to make it to the championship.
Hey, war ready, fellas, let's go.
Right here, guys. Entering
a war.
No weak link. No weak link.
Let's go.
And one extra team.
Hey!
keep it going.
That's a hell of a game. Offense, 146 points in three games. 146 in three games.
Strong link. Like I said before, after the Saints game, there's no team that can beat y'all. The only team that can beat y'all is this right here.
Hey, it's going to be shocking the world, guys. Nobody giving us a chance at hell. Nobody giving us a chance. They're going to say, remember week one. They're going to say they lost by 30. They're going to say, oh, they got lucky with these ones. 146 points in three games. Defense letting up damn near nothing. This is ours, okay? Shock the world on me. Shock the world on three. One, two, three.
Shock the world!
And just like that, they were going to the championship game. They knew that if they could beat the Bishop Gorman Gators, the toughest team in the league, and win the championship, they would no doubt shock the world.
Hold them down. That's what we do. What they really know about our spirit, my Aggies. That's a 9-0 season, my Aggies. Las Vegas Valley, we run, my Aggies.
So the Junior Aggies suited up to do their famous march toward the field together for the very last time. Only this time, it was in a championship game.
Let's go!
yard, man.
Keep it up, guys. Just keep fighting. Keep fighting. Just return one right now. Check it out.
Who's that, y'all?
If they come here, we gotta get out of Aggie Special.
We gotta go back to Billy going to DN and you going back to tackle. It's gotta be automatic.
Tense standoff between the two teams, the Aggies were barely behind. Then, Marco Sandoval, the right offensive guard, took a fall and didn't get back up. Mother Marta Sandoval held her son's hand. Coaches could do nothing but give words of encouragement as he lay in the middle of the field in obvious agonizing pain. He had a broken femur and was out of the game, possibly affecting his dream for a future in football. This seemed to change the Aggies' momentum. Though they were determined to leave everything they had left on the field, injured, battered, and bruised, the Aggies started slipping behind. After all the dust cleared, with not a second left to play on the clock, the final whistle blew. The Junior Aggies lost the championship, and the kids were devastated. Against all odds, this group of kids battled every step of the way to get here, using football as a tool. With it, they learned the art of structure, the importance of discipline, the sense of brotherhood, commitment, loyalty. They learn the value of family. Things they will take with them to high school. Things they can use to become better people in the future. Things they can later teach their families. Today, as a family, they committed themselves to accomplishing one thing: to shock the world. Little did they know, as far as parents, families, and coaches knew, they had already done just that. But at that age, understandably, this group of kids were in pain, and the coaches were not too far from feeling the same. After a couple of moments consoling their players, I asked the coaches how they felt.
None. No one likes to lose. The kids play the hell of a game, though.
It hurts. It hurts. Not for me, but for the kids, and seeing how hard work, how much work they put in, and see how ready they were pre-game, I just feel for them.
Oh, of course they deserve to win a championship. Not everything goes our way. The worst part about football is there's winners and losers.
How do you think the kids feel right now?
The kids are crushed, absolutely crushed. And in all honesty, no matter what I say, they're not going to feel better right away.
Yeah, a lot of them are down. They have no reason to keep their heads down. They played a good game.
If you could tell them all together, in simple words, why they shouldn't be down, what would you tell them?
Because they're all loved by all the coaches and their teammates. Losing hurts, but it's going to make them better. It's going to make them better when you go to high school. They're a good bunch of kids. So they'll do good. And 2 years from now, they'll be gone.
This is the second season in a row that I had to sit here and watch kids cry. I'll be there for you. These 5 words I swear to you. When you breathe, I wanna be the air for you. I'll be there for you. I live and I die for you. I steal sun from the sky for you.
This sucks.
Damn.
It hurts. It truly does. But hey, I love each and every one of you guys.
I'm seriously so proud of you guys. Seeing you guys build over these past 3, 4, 5 seasons is huge. Seeing that change, I can't wait to see you guys keep going at that next level. Seeing where you came from the beginning till now, how you guys became a family, how you guys did things the right way. It sucks, it hurts, it's gonna hurt for a while. But learn from it. Give 100% in every single thing you do. If you can tell yourself that, then you guys are truly winners inside, okay? That's all I ask of you guys. Be able to look at yourself at the end of the day in the mirror and tell yourself, I'm proud of myself. Everybody else will be proud of you. Your friends, your parents, your coaches, whoever else. Your guys' football journeys aren't done here. You guys are gonna go to high school, and you guys get to keep going. Be proud of it. I don't care that it says runner up. Be proud of this. Take pictures with this. You busted your butt, okay? Remember shutting out Green Machine. Remember sending the Wolfpack home on their own field. Remember beating the Federals, beating the Saints, beating all these teams. Remember the good parts of the season and learn from the bad.
Everybody out here worked their ass off. They gave everything they had out there. That's all we ask for as coaches. I ain't never been to a championship game. This is my first one, and it was with you guys. So from me to you, thank you guys. Every day, you've always done it. Every single game, you've impressed me. Okay, I love you guys.
Hug your mom, hug your dad, hug your grandparents, brother, sister, whoever's here to see you. Thank them for all the hard work they put into it. They put a lot. Parents, thank you guys. Thank you for all your support. We truly appreciate it. You made each and every one of us coaches excited for practice every day. Thank you guys for making us want to do this. For making the sport we love that much more fun. For getting to see you guys progress every day. So thank you all. Truly, truly, truly. We'll get a family break. Everyone think of Marco. I'll try to get a hold of him. Let everyone know how he's doing.
Family coach.
Hey. Boys.
Let's go. Family. It's on you.
Family on me. Family on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Family!
Woo! Was I ever right in wanting to lay down beside all the dreaming? Think that I'll stand up with all my might and take my chances. All the while, you're bittersweet and full of favors. Just begging to take the test. In a way, I was demanding. Glad that I'm grounded, 'cause all I ever wanna be is real. No safer than sorry, no plans to ignore it. I'm keeping this glory like the color of the day.
When I started to tell this story, I had no idea what it was going to be about. But now I do. I think it's about the importance of family and support. How guidance could lead someone straight onto a field of champions. I think it's weird how our kids look at us as heroes, yet they have no idea how big of heroes they are to us. So we guide them as best we can and prepare them for the future. And they all grow up fast. These kids, soon to be adults, are about to begin a journey, their entire adult life. Today, together, they became a unit. They became a team. Most importantly, they became a family. I believe it was because of the support of all the families, the parents who made sure they got to practice every day, who cheered them on, who consoled them. Your children may not win a championship game. They might not ever even make it there. In fact, your child may not ever even want to join a league or a sport. But as parents, it's our job to support them, to value them, in anything that they do, so that one day, with a little bit of our guidance, love, and support, they can become champions in life and shock the world.
Shook, man. You ain't built for a spirit as a nigga can be.